I think it's my fan.
Well, these are really good at picking up voices, but blocking out other shit.
Yep. Yeah, so like they're the opposite of sensitive. I said sensitive before, that was wrong.
They're selective.
Yes. All right.
They're like me in high school.
Welcome back to y'all. Play that memes, Latin boy.
Rude Juju.
Oh, caboose.
And we're here with
Lazy Regenesis.
I was actually wondering. I should have asked how we were gonna do that. And we're here with Breath of the Wild. A little late, but we got it. And thanks to Lazy Regenesis, she's allowing us to play it. So.
So we're gonna let her play.
So we're gonna yes. All right. So we're gonna start a new game. Pretty sure I'm on my profile. Yeah, yep. We are.
Okay.
Hit new game.
That's a good way to start.
Right?
Hope I'm not deleting save data.
I guess we do overwrite.
I would be so mad.
It's good to check.
Might want to turn it down.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially since you can't back up save data.
Nintendo presents.
Once it's gone, it's gone.
Well, like, so I can't back it up. I can't move it to my system. I can't, like, it's just stuck here.
And people laughed at the PS3 for having an SD card.
Yeah, why aren't we just using your system for this?
Because I don't want to dock it.
Oh, yeah.
Because I don't have a screen protector, and I won't get it until April.
Oh, my God. Just be fucking careful.
No.
Wait,
like,
they don't
have
screen protectors until April?
Well,
what the fuck?
Well, now I'm concerned, because that means we have to play on my Switch till we're done.
Oh, yeah. We committed. Bless
yeah,
you.
Yeah, that's true. So, okay.
Well, but it's on my profile, so...
Yeah, that... Whatever.
Well, like, you can still move your dock somewhere else. Because, like, we can just use his dock. If that's what...
It's not the dock that's the problem. It's the system itself.
Well, the Switch can just go in there.
It just means that she can't play when we're playing, even though you're part of the series and we'll play at points.
Yeah. Look at that hot piece of...
Don't make it weird, man.
I forgot that I was supposed to be part of my Zelda meeting.
Do we need to? Because it sounds like you need to be a part of that.
I will be in the chat, so I will be live chatting while I play Zelda. It's fine. I'm technically on the clock.
Right. Should you put
on the clock with who?
I'm on the clock with you. I'm on the clock with them. They'll understand.
You double booked.
No, yeah. They won't.
Yeah, man, I never book anything on Fridays anymore.
Well, I didn't
All
have that.
All three
I didn't
people
have that, choice.
That ever want to hang out, I'm just like, can't, man, it's Friday.
Plus two of us are here.
He said thinking Chris only had you as a friend.
All right.
That was my first time seeing this on the TV. When I played this, I was in handheld mode.
Have you, like, how much have you played handheld versus actually docked?
I've played about 90% handheld.
Really?
I've played 100% handheld.
It looks good.
I bought the system to be my new handheld system.
This is it.
Yeah,
I've committed.
Now I have two handheld systems.
It's a Vita that I like. No, because I like my Vita.
It's a Vita that I play for more than Danganronpa.
Well.
That you can play on Steam now. I hope I get a Switch version soon. I want to see, like, Gravity Rush 3 on the Switch. Just to hell with it.
God, that would be rough.
Gravity Rush 3. Fuck the Vita.
So...
Caught Gravity Rush.
If
lives.
You could hear Zelda over our talking, I don't like her British accent.
Yeah, I remember in a, I think it was either in Shovel Knight or You Don't Know Jack, we're talking about Zelda's voice, mm-hmm. and I said it's not very British. I clearly didn't hear it well enough beforehand.
No, you didn't.
It's not good British, I guess.
It's not, first off, yeah, because it's an American person doing a British accent.
Are we sure?
Yes.
Who is it?
It's some new voice actress.
Why would you do
that? Oh, well, she's new.
But she's not, like, actually...
No, but then why would you just get a British person to do the voice?
Exactly.
No?
Yeah.
Just get the guy who played Ryan.
But then my other problem with it is...
Voice a woman.
Hold on, I really like how the pants just go bloop.
Oh yeah, they just pop on.
Oh, I choke.
I'm pretty sure no one else in the game has an accent, like an English accent.
No, no one else does.
It's just her.
No, I'm going to get her name wrong, but Mipha.
Oh, Mipha does. Yeah.
Mipha does.
But she's a fish person. Maybe they talk different.
The other Zoras don't.
The other Zoras don't talk. Well, actually, the only one you hear is Sidon.
Again, my other favorite is that or if the they don't too. Have any speaking parts, they don't replace the voices at all, so you still get like the Japanese voice actors and actresses. Mm. Like, this is not an American person playing Link.
Yeah.
Like, they didn't bother.
They're never going
Why
to.
Why bother?
Yeah, exactly. That's a lot of work.
So,
does like everyone in the Japanese version have like a Tokyo accent, and then Zelda speaks with like an Osaka dialect?
I don't fucking know. I didn't look that up.
That'd be funny though.
That's different though.
I know it is.
Wait, that'd be like they're having a southern accent.
Yeah, because she'd be a hick.
Link, we gotta go get that Triforce.
Fine, oh, Hokkaido accent.
That's still not.
That's still, yeah. You get where I'm going with this, though.
Kind of.
I guess.
If you flipped it.
It would be as if she had a very regal accent.
Yeah. If she spoke from the Edo period.
Well, I mean, there is a basically.
And like, everyone else speaks modern Japanese.
Like, if she were Cyan from Final Fantasy VI. What are you...
Brightness on your TV is weird, because this looks way brighter.
Well, I did set it. Mm. Like, all my HDMI port, like, channels
are set the same.
Custom, yeah.
Also, apparently that TV may have been thrown around in the back of my trunk.
Not my TV.
So, as far as, like, progress on this game goes, for the four people in the room, there's one person who's beat it. There's one person who hasn't done any of the major dungeons yet. Actually, I guess two people. And then how?
I was about to say, where
far
are we
have
going?
You gotten?
So on my file, my original file, I didn't get very far at all. Like, I haven't met Impa yet.
Okay.
So I'm the tour guide throughout this. Then.
Well, two people that haven't gotten to Kakariko, I guess. No,
oh.
You have.
No, I've gone to.
She's gone to Kakariko.
Kakariko, Hateno, so. And I made it to Zora.
Okay.
Then
but
you
haven't
started that.
Yeah. I haven't done anything to really further the story. I've just done shrines and scavenging.
So also, I guess we should set some ground rules because this game is fucking big and long.
It's not long, it's just big.
It's just big. Well, it's long because it's big.
Technically.
But Waka so, Waka. I think we want to basically say, like, we want to try and get as many shrines as we can as we are approaching them, I guess, would be the best way to do it. If,
yeah,
especially
along
if
the
it's
way.
Really easy to get to.
Yeah.
Korok seeds. Like, I'm basically, like, if we
it comes
if we remember,
in handy with the weapon stash and stuff like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, just do it along the way.
Yeah, like, if we remember them, let's do it. But, it, like, some of them are just far out of the way and stupid.
Should I limit how much scavenging I do?
Then? Yes, otherwise it'll take the control from you.
I like collecting stuff. We may need it for later.
We ain't gonna need nothing.
Like, you can you can definitely scavenge some things, and then we'll definitely scavenge some things, like, in between in recording sessions.
Fine, I won't go out of my way to go collect stuff.
Yeah. We're just gonna keep focused.
Keep it
streamlined. Yeah, this is the Link any percent category.
And then I guess, like, when it comes to side quests, probably not, because, like, a lot of the side quests really just get you materials and stuff.
They just get you rupees.
Yeah.
Almost every side quest just gets you rupees.
Well, so the very first side quest gets you some nice equipment, and that's mostly, that's pretty much all I'm going to say about that. But
what side quest?
The first one.
This one?
No. This is a main quest.
Then I have no idea what side quest you're talking about.
I think
about.
I know what he's talking
it's
about.
It's with the two treasure hunting brothers.
Oh, but that
that's
it's
the
still
first side quest.
It's still just rubies.
You call that
nope.
First one?
Okay.
If you're talking about quest rewards, then it's technically nothing. Everything
yeah,
you find
yeah.
there, you can find there without even doing the quest.
Where are we? I guess that's true.
Because every side quest that I've actually completed and, like, turned into someone, they just give you rupees. There's
actually, the first side quest, you don't get anything out of it.
Yeah, because you don't. Yeah. So, like...
For stupid reasons.
Yeah, there is no reason to really do a side quest.
Yeah, pretty much.
Because there's no, like, armor or, like, anything like that locked behind any of them.
So, are we going to mention how the Temple of Time is not in the right place?
No, it's not.
Well, everything's not in the right place.
But we don't even technically...
Most things are in the right place.
We don't even technically know where they are in we don't technically know where it is in Twilight Princess in relation to
Ocarina. The Temple of Time?
Yeah.
That is true, because it's in a completely different place than it is in Ocarina.
Well, and there's also the idea that, like, you're not... The castle is not always going to be in the same place, because, like, every, maybe, say, let's say 100 or so
every
years.
Every generation.
Yeah. The foundation. It's like, you don't just rebuild Shea Stadium. You tear it down and you build a new stadium.
Across the parking lot. Yeah.
Across the parking lot from Shea Stadium.
This is my favorite response.
Dude, some of the dialogue choices for Link are pretty good.
Please be careful.
Paraglider, please.
Please don't.
Just the only one that would have been my favorite, but you just made it up, was the horse one. Mm-hmm. It was like, oh, do you want me to teach you how to mount horses? I'm on a horse.
The roasting them on a fire will make them more nutritious.
This is my favorite part, too.
But they're then funny. He's like, I'm not going to eat that. It was on the ground.
I'm going to throw it at your head.
Fucking floor chicken.
I was going to throw it away anyways.
All right. Speaking of Korok seeds, we can get our first one right now.
I was super mad. Oh.
Oh, yeah. There's that, too. Head
for the point marked on the map in your Sheikah Slate. So is she talking through the Sheikah Slate or your actual mind?
I think she's
in your head. I never really
Zelda's
thought about
always
it.
Always had telepathic abilities.
She's special, yeah.
Yeah, she fucking telepathically tells you to go find her in the dungeon of Hyrule Castle in Link to the Past.
Princess Zelda, the Charles Xavier of Hyrule.
I mean, if you consider Zelda, Spirit no! Tracks, if you consider Spirit Tracks, she does plane walk.
Yeah, she is a ghost.
I was so mad when Scott figured this out.
Yeah, Scott basically saw... So Hobotron was playing this. That's actually how we started my file. Was Hobotron playing it, and he literally just saw that and was like, oh boy, and just jumped into it.
And I flipped my shit, because I was like, what the fuck?
Because the only ones we had seen by that point were just like the ridiculous, stupid, hard-to-find ones, and he was just like, just literally fell into this.
And I think at this point, I had already left the plateau.
Yeah.
When he figured it out, I was like, well, great, now I have to go back.
No, we were going to like the last shrine.
I accidentally found out about it because I was like, oh, look, a sword over there. And I jumped off and fell into the pool. I was like, oh.
Okay.
This is like, we've been doing in this area.
I like
well,
how
the first time I just swam into it. I'm like, right? That's all I need to do?
Seed, please.
I don't think you're going to.
I like how when you pick up the...
No, you can make it.
I can make it. I just can't dash.
I think you can still dash.
Don't dash.
It is. I think at this point it is a well-known fact. But in case you haven't played this game before, your stamina meter from Skyward Sword is back and
better.
I mean, it's very crucial, but it's basically the same. Like, there's difference.
No, there is a difference. There's no stamina fruit.
Well, there's no stamina fruit, and there's no building it up.
Yeah.
So I guess in that way it is improved. So
wait, what do you mean? Yes, there is building it up.
You don't make your stamina bar greater in Skyward Sword.
Oh, okay. Yeah. You were saying two things for two different games.
Yes. And so the point I was trying to make is that if you're trying to climb or swim, you can dash, but it wastes your stamina bar. But people have found out that it actually like makes it so that you travel less further.
Yeah,
than you
I feel
would
like
if you never dash.
Well, goddamn.
Yeah, I feel like it's like not as beneficial.
It is when climbing.
Well, if you have, like, the climbing
shit.
Set.
Oh, shit. Just go.
You have another tree branch.
Oh, yeah. Wait. Yeah, you do.
You also
and
have
a woodcutter's axe.
I know.
And a rusty-ass sword.
I'm taking my time with that.
I'm going to take my time with that axe.
We do need that axe for later, even though we'll find another one.
Oh. No, I just bomb trees.
Yeah.
Do you
It's
really?
Free.
The bomb can just solve anything the axe does.
Bombs are what you're supposed to do for cutting down trees and fishing.
Link's, yeah, that's true.
Link's a traditional good old boy.
I mean, he's gonna see you.
That's true. I need that.
You can throw the tree branch at him.
We all go fight.
It does double damage.
You gotta throw it at once it's about to break.
Well, you have a club now, so.
Yeah, you
and
do.
You took
hey,
his.
Look at there. You got a club.
Now you got two.
That's mine.
Not anymore.
Yeah, you ain't gonna need it. Not where you're going.
Oh, I didn't pants. I didn't get those.
You didn't get the trousers? Really?
No, I bought them.
You don't remember those?
Wait, really?
So you stuck with capris the whole time?
No, I just went straight to Kakariko and bought those ones.
You don't remember those from the E3 demo?
No.
They
that
actually...
That was last year.
Oh. Did they do that?
Yeah. They actually also had the warm doublet in that one.
Yeah, they had to show you how the warm doublet worked.
Yeah.
And that temperatures can cause pain.
You're going the wrong way.
No, you're going fine. If you want to climb the tower to get the bow.
So when they came around and did...
You're going there anyway.
So don't do... Fine.
We'll do that when we get to it.
Oh, no, I'm telling him.
Yeah, but...
I was actually really mad when I found out about that.
Yeah, if you want to start with a good bow, go up there.
Well, when I played the demo, when they brought it to DC...
They were like, don't go up there.
No. The guy was like, so I've seen pretty much everyone do everything, so nothing can really surprise me. And I was like, has anybody tried to climb the castle? And he goes, yeah, I guess. So I did
it. I guess? So you didn't see that?
No. So I climbed it, and I guess because I climbed all the way up there, he was like, holy shit. He's like, I didn't know that was up there. And I was like, ha-ha. Gotcha.
Ha, gotty.
Let's see. No, stop moving. Nope. Fuck. Well,
yeah, the,
fine.
The sneaking in this game I find very tough.
Without
the sound meter,
without stealth modifications, it's tough.
Not necessarily. It's just that it really depends on how fast or how slow you move.
I think there's
the sound meter in the bottom right hand corner there.
Yeah.
Cause like that's what at least what I've noticed, especially with the
lizards. Never have good luck with
that. We're in here, don't run past that treasure chest.
Yeah. No, I know, but like I wanna see like so when you're moving, that's loud. So
yeah.
If you like you know.
Yeah,
it's super slow. But we only have 20 minutes an episode.
Four minutes.
You know, just let me collect this.
And you get a decent bow here.
We'll just start off with that.
They try to trick you with this bow, and they're like, that's all that's here.
Yeah, yep, that's don't even bother looking at the top. Shut up. Because, I mean, that's what, like, so I did that, and then I found the soldier's bow, and then basically you just kind of wind up there again anyway, and I was kind of, it's like, why... When it comes to like a I guess an efficiency perspective, like you're just gonna wind up there anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Just wait. And we can also catch butterflies, but
not without the sneak gear.
What kind of bird is this?
Catch them.
Well, yeah, but it's just tough.
It's also expensive.
What
sneak gear? The sneak gear is expensive. Yeah.
I can't remember. Can I take them on right now?
Yeah, you can take them on if you want. You can also find a way to blow up that barrel.
Yeah.
We don't have a way.
Not right. You could, I think, throw the Boko Club at it and it'll explode. But
yeah, you can.
Okay.
You have
to sure?
Be... Yeah, I think so. I think you can. If you throw a weapon, it will do it.
Yeah, maybe.
Ah, fuck it.
Yes, I've thrown a boomerang in an exploding barrel before and it blew it up.
But, yeah, regular arrows will not blow it up.
Yeah. Yo, guys, fuck y'all. Or just beat them.
Yeah, like, go and whale them. Whale on them.
Take their club, take their meat.
Take their food.
When I did this, the first time I was like, I get their dinner? This is fantastic.
Yeah, you earned it.
That unlights it. He's just like,
well, he's not going to sheath it on fire. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, but it always made more sense than, like,
well, okay,
Ocarina
I think the thing
of Time
that...
in Majora's Mask that it was, like, a little stick. And it's like, yeah, waving it. You
yeah,
put
yeah.
It out. But this is a giant fucking club.
And he just goes, like, done, gone. Yeah.
Well,
in still perfect condition.
They had already made the animation for the torch, so they didn't want to do another one for that.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Can, like, roll?
No.
No.
I like the idea that, like, one of them is telling him about how good at archery he is, and the other one's just like, all right.
I bet you can't hit that thing 20 meters that way in the eyeballs.
I think of it more like, hey, watch me shoot this arrow. Man, you shot that arrow.
Bam!
I've never seen that ever.
So,
you really shot the hell out of that thing.
The damage multiplier for a sneak strike is actually times 8.
So times 8 the power of your weapon.
Dude. Yeah, so...
Oh, well.
So you, there's certain things for other... There's certain damage modifiers for the other things, like the... throwing a weapon does 2 times the damage. It's the same thing as a critical hit.
Can you sneak strike with a bow?
No.
That'd be too strong. Yep. It's alright, just hit B as fast as you can. Oh,
I wouldn't do too bad.
Or X, I guess.
I'm trying to...
Jesus.
My favorite thing about the jump attack is the fact that, like, you're hitting him down so hard that apparently he just, like, bounces off the ground.
Well, no, for some reason, every weapon when you do a jump attack does 2 hits. It does the hit when you hit them, and then another hit happens when you hit when it hits the ground.
Yeah, maybe, the shockwave does damage.
Maybe because of the, invulnerability period. It's like just short.
It makes
enough.
More sense with bigger weapons. Like, it's a shockwave doing that, but when, like, it's a wooden club, you're like, come on now.
It just sounds to me like they programmed it so that shockwave can damage people, but then they just didn't bother to, like, make it so that an enemy that gets hit with the actual sword also has, like, invincibility frames so they don't get hit by the shock. But I feel like they just felt like not programming that out.
Please watch for falling rock.
I didn't know. I don't remember it saying that.
How does it also know that?
Yeah, it knows, like, that it's not even activated.
Well, no, it knows that it's buried. That's the thing. How is it that?
And it's the only
maybe it's
tower
because
in the
it's
game.
Inactive. It's,
yeah.
Inactivated.
Well, no, but
because everything else is orange, but this one is just dead.
Wait, does this tower raise all of the other towers?
Yes.
It raises all the towers and all the shrines. Most of the shrines.
We'll see it right here happening. That's not us. Oh, that is us.
Yeah, see, look, that one's still orange.
See, there
okay,
you go.
It is.
See? Yeah.
Oh, I thought that was just another angle
that
of that one.
Yeah.
So that one detail. In Death Mountain just... Oh, Death Mountain's that big.
Yes.
Because it's still that far away.
Yeah.
There's a reason it's called Spectacle Rock.
Spectacle Rock's on the other side of the map.
Fine. Is Spectacle Rock in this game?
Yes, it is.
That's everything's nice. In this game. Everything. It's
even
a culmination of Zelda's.
What? No, there's a lot of stuff that is in this game that's just in ruins. Like Hyrule Castle,
like Lon
Town
Lon
is there.
Ranch.
Lon Lon Ranch. The Mirror
really?
Of Twilight is there.
Yeah, there was a tweet about Lon Lon Ranch.
It's right.
Is
and
it
it's,
in disarray?
It's completely destroyed. But you're still able to tell what it is.
Marin ain't there.
Yeah, she's definitely not there.
She got killed by the moon.
Neither
and
is
we
Mario
have our
or
first
Luigi.
Map.
I liked the new eerie item get fanfare that it's in here.
Dee, 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 dee.
Yeah, the little doo 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 doo. You're like, ooh, that's spooky.
Yeah. I didn't know I was playing a horror game.
Wait, where is he? Oh.
Who you are.
Look at me, arrows.
Try to remember, Link.
Remember, Simber. Also,
are you also noticing that Ganon's not there right now?
Yeah, he doesn't show up until
because
now.
Until right now?
Because he's like, oh shit, the spires are up.
Oh
yeah,
shit,
well,
the towers are there.
Because he's been dormant until he's like, something is happening.
You put the Sheikah energy back into all the Guardians.
So, like, what if you just went to Hyrule Castle before you did that?
Oh shit, yeah.
Well, no, he's there. So.
Oh, he's still there, yeah.
Well, you can't physically go there.
Yeah, you can.
No, you can't, because it's off the plateau.
You cannot
you can
do
climb.
Anything.
Dude, I can. You want me to do it right now? I can climb down the plateau.
We tried doing it once, and once we hit a point, Link fell.
I can do it right now. There's a spot that I found where I just climbed down it, and I was like, oh.
Okay, maybe. Because, like, there was a...
Well, how... Dude, speedrunners beat this in an hour. They just immediately climb down the plateau and go to Ganon's castle.
Well, they also
so there has
Epona.
To be a sweet spot where it doesn't activate.
They had to get to a point where they could use amiibos, too, because a lot of them used Epona.
Well, yeah, to just run there.
Yeah.
Well, you can turn amiibos on right now.
No, you can't.
Really?
No,
really?
I thought you just go and do it.
Oh. There you go.
Because we tried that. Because
they don't want to do... They can't give you a fucking horse right now. Actually, I want to wait until a very specific point in the game where we can do that. So I think that's good for the first episode, actually.
Yeah.
Sure.
We made it here.
We got our first objective.
Yeah, we're going to go find... climb. First, we gotta climb down.
One
spire.
Objective an episode.
Fuck.
That's reaching far.